Hello everyone, my name is Maartje and I'm from Crafty Crow Designs. Today I'm sharing a center picture window card with you in a fall theme. This piece of paper is going to be the base of the card, and these other two pieces of paper are basically the same size and they are die cut from the Spiffy Speckles paper. Then from the same pattern paper I have die cut this central window. And with the same die, I also die cut this piece of paper, but I cut off the little flaps on the side. Then this piece is going on the front of the card. This is from the fall fling paper. And then I die cut the two side panels, also from the fall fling paper, which are going on the inside of the card, on the two sides. And then I also stamped and colored these two trees from the tree before and after set. Now let's get started on the inside of the card. So on the top you have the card base. And the bottom two pieces are the Spiffy Speckles paper. And those are going to act as the background on the inside. And I'm making sure that I'm lining it up exactly with the card base. That is also why I close the card a little bit, so I can really press it into the fold of the card, and this makes sure that everything is positioned perfectly. And this is the window part which will be positioned in the center. And for this, it is important that you line up the score line of that center window with the score line of the card base. Now I'm moving on to the background, which you will see through the window. I only put some tape runner on the left hand side of this background piece, but not yet on the right hand side. And the reason for that is that I want those flaps from the center window to be hidden behind the background. To adhere the grass, I'm also lining it up with the score line of the card base. And I'm also making sure that you will still see the grass when you look through the window. So that is also why I positioned the grass a little bit higher than the center picture window itself. To adhere the grass, I just folded it over and then I put back the background on top of it. And I'm going to do the exact same thing with the center picture window part. But before I start with that, I first want to make a score line on the tree, because I want to position the tree exactly in the middle of the grass. And this score line die is also included in the center picture window die set. And now I'm adhering the tree with some tacky glue to the grass. And I do need to wait a little bit and play with it to position it right and to get the glue to dry. But as you can see, that tacky glue, it dries pretty quickly, and I'm really happy about that. And now that it has dried, I can adhere the rest of the card. So I put some tape runner on the background and I'm removing the release paper from the center picture window part. And now I can just fold over the card base on top of the background and the window. And then everything is positioned perfectly. And now I can start with decorating the rest of the inside of the card. So for these two side panels, I stamped and colored a couple of leaves and also the trails. So it looks like the leaves are blowing through the wind. And the tree has lost its leaves, and the leaves are just going everywhere. And I'm adhering them down with a little bit of tacky glue. And now I'm going to put them inside the card. And for this, I'm just using some tape runner. And I'm making sure that I position those sides exactly in the middle. And on the inside of the card, I also wanted to have part of the sentiment. So for the inside, I stamped Falling for You. And for the front of the card, it's going to say, I'll never stop. So in total, it reads, I'll never stop falling for you, which I think is really cute. And I die-cut this banner with one of the dies that also comes with the center picture window die set. And to decorate the inside of the card a little bit more, I also put some leaves on a little bit of acetate. And I'm gluing them to the window itself. And this really gives a dynamic look. It makes them look as if they are just floating in the air. With the acetate, it can take a while before the tacky glue dries. So when I positioned the leaves, I was careful not to move the leaves too much around on the acetate, because otherwise they would just fall off again. So you need to then wait for a little bit that it is adhered a bit more, or you just need to, of course, use a different type of glue. But I like using tacky glue because it allows some wiggle room. So if you're not happy with how you positioned it, you can still reposition. And now for the front of the card, I stamped I'll never stop. And I stamped it on the Falfling paper, which I also used on the inside of the card as the background for the window. And this little tree, it still has all its leaves on it, but as you can see, they are already turning in the beautiful fall colors. And now that the front is done, I can just adhere it down with my tape runner. And I'm making sure that I position the front exactly in the center of the card base. And that finishes up the card. So here I'm going to show you what it looks like in total. So here you have the inside. You could decorate it even more with some more grass in the background, but I kind of liked it like this. I really hope you enjoyed watching this video. And if you did, do not forget to subscribe and give it a thumbs up. Thank you for watching, and see you next time.